re-implementing the proc tree again, but now I have a good one. And I also whipped out the little async function to populate the tree asynchronously. I can do about 100,000 entries in about 10 seconds, which is amazing. The next thing, it crashes whenever I close the project. So that's not great. So the next thing I'm working on is basically debugging that crashing issue. So I made a couple test classes for async. So we're gonna try that. So let's go ahead and try this. All right. So let's see if this crashes the game. So we run this. It all worked. Stop. Okay, that worked. So it's the way we're interacting with the function is what it seems. At least that was, okay, so that was a short task. Async string long. Let's try the long task. Maybe it's just the long task that's broken. Nope. Both worked, huh? All right, let's hook back into our actual test. We know it's working here. So we'll do this like this and this, and then we'll just, don't need that. Something like this. Come down here, print everything. Call stop tasks. Call. try to break the reference to the values that we pass in as references. So let's take a look. This guy got a reference to this and a reference to this. Depth activated bounds might also be a reference, so before we do that, let's try this. Break all the links to shit. Make an empty array. All right, let's test this. You can see we're moving around just fine, but in the background we're doing thousands of inserts in the tree, and the only lag here is from the actual print line statement at the end. Nope, that's a crash. Okay. Pass a raw UI, so garbage collector has no idea. When you quit, the U object destroy the test, thinks he's still alive and trying to use it. T weak object pointer. Make async.
Best way to save variable in actor, two conditions. Actor was not destroyed when the callback was called actor, which event used and callback was not destroyed. You don't need to create in every task, but if the task contains any variables, they don't be reset it automatically. Jesus Christ. My use case spun a lot of this in that affecting if possible. Whole spun reactor is not a main thread, plug itself, plug for. I'm just doing some research here. Instance edible expose on spawn were checked. Let's take a look at ours. Instance edible expose on spawn. Alright, so I guess the next thing I need to do is go test my. Hold up. We need to pass something that requires a pass by reference.
something like this. And then go back to our level blueprint. Oh, shit. There we go. Short. Reference range sharp. Make an integer right here. Okay. Let's see if we can crash it like this. We're actually trying to crash it right now. We wanted to crash on a simple one so that we'll understand the cause. So now it has a reference to the array. No, that wasn't good enough. What about if I pass a reference to the node? Okay. Let's add our node in here. And hold a reference to them. And it's just fine. No, oh fuck, I didn't mean to click that. Damn it. Close this. Fuck off. And then here. That works.
Interesting. Let's hook back into our main function. Fine. I must not have saved my changes. Oh. It might be that I'm holding a reference to the array output, is what I'm kind of thinking. Thank you.
see if it crashes now. Ah, I think we found it. It's not any of the data I'm passing in, it's the data I'm getting out, is what it seems like.
I need to dereference it somehow.
Okay, what am I doing with the output here? What's a soft object reference? Let me try something. Fuck, man.
Shit.
Alright, I kind of expected it to do that, but still, fuck. Go grab my fuzzy robe in a second. Actually, I'm gonna get it before I continue. Go ahead and get comfy. Looks like we'll be here for a while.
Okay, I'm back. Let's see. Ooh. GC. Okay.
Let's try passing the data in the struct. Point cloud node depth, activated core bounds. Point cloud node depth, activated core bounds. Save that. I'm gonna try to pass these around as structs instead. Yeah, this is fine. And then I'll also add Come on.
Fuck.
This one's a real challenge. Alright, let's keep plugging away. We have the thing, it does what we want. We just have to be able to close it without crashing the game. Let's go ahead and crash it. I didn't mean to click it again. If I can fix this, I'd like to just make a texture pack plugin today, too. But I gotta fix this first. This doesn't work. This doesn't work. Is that much work? Alright, let's burn one while this recovers from its slowness, and then I'm gonna crash it. Oh god. Got a big old dump of resin on the edge of the mouthpiece of the bong. Gross. Level. That's not it.
It's probably... Can I even breakpoint into that? No. Oh, it's not. Okay, so hang on. How do I set the damn...
It's the game mode, right? I give. Please, mercy. Okay. It's like godlike. As long as I can figure out how to make it not crash the whole thing when you close it. Like, the processing itself is fucking great. Like, look at this. 10,000 nodes. Alright, let's make sure that it's not the, hold up. Octree. There it is, and maybe with a delay. Hmm. How do we do this? So, all the nodes pretty much hold references to all the other nodes. So how do I think what it is all these nodes have references to all the other nodes, so to kill them I have to kill the root, maybe. So that's what I'm going to try to do. Not this. There it is. Think we may be getting closer. Okay, I forgot. Don't mouse over the fucking tree actor, because it fucking shits a brick. It has to stay. Okay, so now we're just going to completely destroy the tree. And then it was like, UE5 GC commands, obj GC. Come on. Fuck. If I destroy all actors, okay. Just looking at shit. I gotta figure out how to make this work. Maybe this will work. Make a new root node. Yeah. And then we save it. And this is temproot, and it is a wrapper.
then we can feed this temporary root here. Break our reference to the tree. And then
alright, so now we're creating a new root and passing it to this instead of the one that we're referencing in our class. And then we're going to set it blank when we're done with it. Let's just see. Alright, fuck it, let's go. Oh shit. We got a bunch of errors, but I think we cracked it. Okay. When we don't pass a reference to the actual tree that we're holding. I almost want to try it like this at first. Alright, we'll try it. We may crash. Let's go. Let's try to kill the temp component. Or let's try to not use the temp component. We just make one, put it in. It's definitely something to do with the tree structure that's getting passed in and manipulated. And I think that I basically have to like quarantine it and then like overwrite the existing tree when it returns.
That's interesting. Instead of doing it like this. So now we just pass in the node and this guy. It's all starting to make sense now. Okay, so I gotta go back to the async. We don't do this here. We do this. Here. Yes.
We got it. We got it. We did it. Hell yeah, dude. All right. Boom. It runs, it runs, it runs. Oh, ho, ho. Oh, ho, 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 ho. Very nice. So now I can do this. What has happened to my variables? Well, here. Try this on for size. Okay, that's sick.
Alright, that's really fucking sick, actually.
Print out the current root, set the current root to the new root, get the root again, print the data again. Skip the array print. It works. Okay. Fun stuff. Now we got real async. Okay, stop this. Okay, let's clean this up and make it do what it's actually supposed to do. When this is done, we would like to do this. That's why I couldn't find it. Okay.
Get rid of this.
Okay. First, prune everything that's not connected. Because we got it working. We don't want any of this experimental shit. Oops. Next, we need to go. It's finally time to go into our proc tree itself. No, I don't kick this off from a function. This is wrong. Point cloud node depth activated bounds async user inputs async insert inputs that is. This is sick. this part or this part. Sync point cloud input.
So we can do it like this. No, not like that. Just, like this. Okay, so if this is valid, then we get the parent of the target. This should have fuck, we need to be saving index, huh? Okay, hang on, we can fix that. Structs node data. This one's an easy one. Now we gotta go to insert child. Okay, so this will change the children we generate. Then I need... Oh, that's all I need. Because now I can just go back up a level. Please don't crash. I don't want to lose any work here. Okay. What the fuck, man?
Alright, and now we have an index here. And we can just all right, now let's simply test it like this. Thank you. That's gonna crash.
Okay. That's fine.
Hello. Sorry, I haven't been paying terribly close attention to chat. We crashed it again. All right. Awesome. I'm in the process of making async functions to do bulk inserts into my op tree and into, and then also create async point cloud generators. I have a few formulas I want to put in there. Shit, which one of these games was it? I think it was this one. No, don't do that. Holy shit. Fuck up everything if I do that. So, apologies if it's boring. It's a pain in the ass, kind of. Yeah, I've been using it to help with some of the, basically is like a pseudo second dev sometimes, with help with figuring out algorithms. It helped me figure out a bunch of the octree math, and it helped me figure out how to make spiral point clouds, and things like that. I'm not using it right now because I know what I'm doing right now. I don't know what I'm doing right now, but I don't think it would either, because this is like, it doesn't have context on this plugin that I'm trying to make work. The plugin is newer than its, basically its training set, but for like math shit and like figuring out like I got it to tell me how to make like a really good looking like spiral galaxy point cloud and stuff like that. Yeah, it's not super, and this like the documentation on this plugin is like laughably bad, so there's a lot of figuring out what to do. I mean, like, in most use cases, this is one that I didn't even remember that I bought a long time ago, but like, it's a async blueprint plugin. It gives you the ability to basically spin off tasks onto separate threads and handle that with events. But I'm trying to make it update like a complicated octree on the secondary thread. And so there's a lot of, if you end up with any references left or anything, it'll crash the game when you close it. So there's a lot of like fucking around with it to get it to work, if that makes sense. Like, it works for, as far as the data insertion, it works great. The problem is it crashes when I close the app. And I actually solved it in the level blueprint, and I can hook that up instead of this, and it'll work just fine. So I'm just like, now I'm taking all the logic that I prototyped for that, and I'm kind of moving it into the actual proctree wrapper itself. And all of this is for like procedural generation shit, basically. Yeah, oh, well, I wish I might actually, hang on. I can show you, okay, so recent levels. I hope this still compiles. I might have broken it with the stuff that I'm doing. Let's try it. Seems to be working. So I can do this procedurally, like sequentially, and in a second we'll get the output, hopefully. And generate like all that stuff for like a universe scale procedural generation thing. It might have just crashed. I may have broken the code because I'm using some of the pieces of the other stuff to do what I'm doing right now, so it's possible that I broke it. But I already have it where you can seamlessly travel in like a universe scale simulation of points. I haven't like made any objects to attach to the points yet or anything, but like I can do things like insert 5,000 points at like a galactic cluster scale, and then take one of those points and insert 1,000 galaxies into it, and then take one of those galaxies and insert 10,000 stellar clusters into it, and then take one of those stellar clusters and insert like 1,000 stars into it, and then take one of those stars and put 8 planets around it. And I could do that already, and you can fly from any level of detail of it to any other. Like, there's no graphics on it. It's just a particle system with the randomization core colors, but like, you can definitely get the idea. It's not working, though. I'm crashed again. But, like, I was doing it all sequentially with basically, like, a big for loop. Yeah, it's crashed. With a big for loop. And it causes the game... Oh, fuck. I clicked the wrong one again. God damn it. It causes the game to load for like 10 seconds while you're populating all that data, and that's fine for your initial star system that you want to spawn the player in, but the idea of this whole structure is to dynamically populate it based on where the player's at. So like I can take the player's path to the root in the octree and only populate the detailed information of entities at certain levels based on where the player's at in this large space. It's not something that I can do at runtime, basically. Like, it, if I were to, like, load in the data with the way that it works now, it would take, like, 5 seconds. So that's no good. So I basically have to find a way to move it off the game thread, or to make it not slow the game down when it happens. The first thing I tried was throttling it. I tried just creating a little event-driven loop and only processing a little bit of it on each frame instead of trying to process the whole thing. And that helped, but the process itself became extremely slow of like not the game, but like the process of like bulk inserting like 10,000 points. Like, bulk inserting 10,000 points took 30 or 40 seconds, which is unacceptably slow. It's not, I can't use that. So I've got this. I had a plugin from a while back, an async blueprints plugin, and I saw that it had updated for 5.1, so I put that in the project. And that's what I'm working on right now. So then I took my octree, I rebuilt it from the ground up, designed to be as fast as possible and also asynchronous. And I'm on the last part of it. Or not the last part of it, because I still have to make a harness around this to proceduralize everything. But the last part of like the meat of the optimization. And it's you create these objects. Like, for one thing that I realized is that whenever I passed in the actual root of the tree here and then did operations on it, I would crash every time I closed. So I have to basically extract its static data and make a new reference to an object and set it as a private object, and do it that way. So that's how I overcame the first one. We don't want this anymore. And we want to Okay, so let's get the things open that we're going to need to finish this, because we're really close to the bulk insert working. So I'm going to need the level blueprint.
Because that's where I have it working. And the tree blueprint, because that's where I want to put it. Okay. It's a time to be very meticulous. Let's go over here and let's see what we're doing exactly. Here's where we start. Async task manager. Did I do that? Yes. Okay, good. No input set. Because I disconnected it, but I can connect another, so. Oh, that's a bounce. Okay. So did I do that? Inputs. Inputs. Where's my call method? In the level. No. Yeah, in the level blueprint. Where am I calling it? Input. 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 Root. The point cloud we made right. Oh god, the horror. No. Yeah, okay, that would definitely be extremely destructive. I was running it on every loop cycle. Oh yeah, well, oh yeah, I've been a software engineer for a while, and I like stuff like this. This is like my equivalent of Legos, if that makes sense. Like, I don't necessarily need a reason to like do something complicated. I just kind of want to try to do it because it's fun. How did I clean it up? Hang on. Completed. That's a two string. None of that matters. Swap the root. I'm doing that. That's another two string. Doesn't matter. Okay. So like literally none of this mattered in the other one. It was just the display. Except for the root set. Let's try it. Oh, I'm in the wrong level. I was like, oh, did it work? No, wrong level. Wait, it is the right level. Did it work?
Okay, here we go. I played some Path of Exile. I played Magic. I actually have a top 1200 I could tournament token I could use in Magic at some point. I've been playing those two mostly lately, but I've been kind of like, I go in phases. Sometimes I'll play lots of video games, and then sometimes I'll do lots of stuff like this. And I've been on a kind of a, like, coding bender. Just doing that for fun. For a while. Okay. I think it's working, and I just didn't have the output rigged up. Let's see if I'm right. Yeah. It worked. Fuck yeah. Oh, yes, that is nice. How many was that? 10,000? Yeah, we got 10,000 children. Let's go. I've gotten to the point. I feel like I'm in the Matrix because I've gotten to the point where I can look at this and actually understand. What it is. Just a scrolling old text, but like, it means something because like these are all quadrants or octants that it's getting divided up into. And each one of these contains a lot of randomization data that you can use to randomize shit with in different locations and different scales. Okay, yeah, I'm not about to scroll through. Okay, clear. Let's do this. Now, this should be fun. Now we can go to the level blueprint. I definitely want to save all. I'm probably going to clone the project at some point today as a backup. I don't like this weirdness. Node wrapper. All right, here we go. $100,000 points, and I'm gonna also break the loop. I don't need to see every single one. And also, we'll make it deeper in the tree. All right, here we go. Here's the real deal test. This is 100,000 points inserted into an octree asynchronously. Let's go. Click. Remove this breakpoint. We're off to the races. But the important thing is... Oh, I might have crashed it, actually. Interesting. Wonder what that was about. Well, fix one thing, break another thing. That's how it goes. I'm going to do something a little bit more fun this afternoon now that I got this working, or that it's close to working. I'm going to make some spherical noise textures and do some skybox stuff, because I think that I can take the lessons I learned from my experiments with volume noise and apply them to the lessons I initially tried to, lessons I initially learned about making sphere noise, and make something pretty cool. Async. I think I had it too long. Everybody seems to be happy. Let's try this again. Okay, I have control. I can move the camera around without lag. Just fine. Meanwhile, it's spinning. And it just returned and updated 100,000 points. That's maybe like 10, 15 seconds, something like that. But 10 or 15 for 100,000 is pretty good. You need about 10,000 on the screen at any given time. And you need to update them in little batches of like hundreds and thousands, and this will be good for that. And it stops without breaking. Oh, hell yeah. All right, so that means I can kind of stop doing this heady, hard shit and do some easy shit for a little bit. So let's make some textures. I'm going to also restart the stream. And change the title. So, I'll be right back.